Hello everyone. Today we're going to learn the new features of Kwik version 1.2. This is the project that we are going to build together. It's a simple photo book about cats. So this is page 1 and this is page 2. As you're going to see later on, this page is also a template for further pages. In order to speed up this video, I've already created a few interactions for this project, but I left the new ones for this tutorial. So let's start with something that most people have asked in the past, animation scaling. So let's pick this third cat here, which is cat 3. And again, this is very important to remind you every time. The better you name your layers, less troubles you're gonna have. So before you start anything, any kind of interactions, take a look at your layer names and see if there's no long names or weird characters on these layers. Otherwise, you're gonna be in trouble. But anyways, so cat 3, and we're gonna click add animation. As you can see now in the bottom, you have two new options. Rotate, which we're not gonna use now, and scale. So let's say this cat is going to scale 110%. And because this button here is clicked, automatically it constrains proportions. And also this is going to delay 3 seconds. Because I have already created the zooms for cat 1 and 2. I'm going to name this cat 3 zoom. And let's say create. And let's do another quick thing here. Let's click the spiral and let's say also add animation. And now we are going to use the rotation. So let's say 360 and it's going to be in 30 seconds. So create. Let's preview our book at this moment. To save time, I've already exported all the images, so this is not going to be necessary. But one new thing in the settings options is this project folder. Now you can define a different location of your folders. Just click browse, select your folder, and Kwik is going to will check this new folder anytime it creates a new project. So let's say save and preview. Here you go. As you can see, the cats are zooming. Let's do it again. You get one, cat 2, and cat 3 zooming, and also you have the spiral rotate in the background. So let's go back to Kwik. Let's go back to page 1 and add a few more things. So as you can see, there is an audio here, but sometimes you want more than one audio per page. So now we can do that. And we'll see also now two different options here. Let's select an audio here. I have this background audio here. And I can say now if this is a long or a short audio file. So in my case, I'll say, hey, this is a regular audio and this is not a README audio file. And this is a new one. The README audio file is files with narration sounds. For example, if you have a long text in your page or it's a story and you want to have your story page read by Kwik, just select README audio file, but this is not the case. And this is going to be a background music, so it can loop forever. So let's save here, and now you have two different audios. Let's do the buttons here. Read to me and I want to read. These are two different ones here. Let's start. I have started already with the I want to read. So I created this put I read. Basically, what the button I read does is to move to another page. So pretty simple, it goes to page cat 2. But the read to me is a new and interesting one. Let's name it correctly. Read to me. This is a read to me. Read to me is a new one too. So what it does, is basically he's gonna autoplay all README files that you may have in each page. So create, and that's it for this page. Let's go to page 2. Page 2, we have text, we have a photo, and we have a few things here. I've already created a button for the previous. Let's create a button for the right one. So let's click here, button right, and see, add button. Let's name it, put next. And this is a go-to page, but there's something, let's select rollover. That's something new here. Now you can just use next or previous. So it's much easier to create next and previous button with before you create your own page. So let's say next, and Kwik will do the rest for you. The same for previous. In our case, it's going to be next. Let's say create. We want our users to be able to not only to read this page, but as well as have the page read to them. So let's add an audio here. And this is the American audio. Now we are going to tell Kwik that this is a page readme kind of a file. Basically what it does, it's pretty much it reads this text here. And it's going to play just one time. Save. Okay. Another thing that you have requested in the past is the possibility to hide and show things in your project. So we have here this, let's open this credit here. And let's simply say this credit is gonna be, it's a new feature called hide layer. It's gonna be hidden and when we start. So let's preview our project at this moment. So we have page 1. We have all the animation that we decide to have. So read to me.
The American Shorthair is a breed of cats, believed to be descended from.
It's reading for you. And if you click the button here. So it's hidden. And if click here,
cats.
Nothing happens. Okay? You're back to the first page.